Okay, thank you very much for your attendance today. Earlier, we had our committee reports, so I call to order our regularly scheduled 5:30 meeting. First item on the agenda is to render invocation, Chaplain Amos Durham. Mr. Durham? Yes, sir.
Let us pray. Father, our God, we thank you for another day. We thank you for your presence in our lives. Thank you for how you guide us and lead us every day. And we're grateful that we can trust in a God like you. Because we know that as you lead us in the right direction. We come asking your blessings again on our county. Pray that your hands will continue to be on us. We ask that you would guide and lead this council meeting tonight. We thank you for all that you do, all that you have done, all that you're yet to do. And we praise your name for it, because you're worthy to be praised. Thank you for the peace you bring. In Christ's name we ask. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Mr. Durham. Jane, would you lead us in our pledge tonight?
Sure. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much. Next we go to item two, presentations, and we have a representation of the Parks Excellent Award by Jim Headley. Jim, how are you? Kevin, your group. Good to see you today.
Good to see you, sir. Thank you, Chairman Horton and members of council, Chairman Walker there, and it's I am from the Columbia area, not from Columbia. Not all bad comes out of Columbia. It's good that you got him back up here so he doesn't have to continue going down that road down 26 and representing the citizens of Spartanburg. But it's certainly indeed an honor and pleasure to be here to represent our 2016 Park Excellence Award to the Spartanburg County Parks Department. As you know, or may know, our profession's vision statement is creating community through people, parks, and programs. And this could be no more evident than the 2016 award that Spartanburg County received for the renovation of Cleveland Park. Spartanburg County's Cleveland Park received the Park Excellence Award recognition this past September at our annual conference in Greenville, South Carolina. And it's in recognition and celebrates the transformation of Cleveland Park into a centerpiece for creative play, community enjoyment, and promotion of physical fitness, as well as assisting with neighborhood revitalization. As you know, back in 2011, Cleveland Park went from a well-loved, visited park to a quiet reminder of a tragic event that happened. The area was so often visited by families sat empty for 4 years with sad reminders of what happened back in 2011. But with the beautiful and the revitalization and the healing that took place over the years, the community came together for a community build project for the playground unit itself. For the build, people came from all walks of life together to put their time, effort, and energy passion back into the love of this park that so many have held for over so many years. Even the family that lost their child came out to the park every single day of the community build event to encourage the support of the volunteers. It was a very, very powerful and emotional week for those of you that were there. At the end of the six-day build, volunteers stepped back and then allowed the construction company to finish all the work. There were over 10,000 volunteer hours that went into the community build portion of this park. And that's what impressed our Awards and Citations Committee, was with the amount of hours that came back and the amount of passion that came back and the amount of vision and creativity that you and council has allowed for the Spartanburg Parks Department to do, and with you backing this important project and the revitalization of that neighborhood. With that, the rebuilt park opened back in March of 2016. Literally over 100 kids poured on the unique, one-of-a-kind, Spartanburg-centric playground, opening with excitement and joy, creating a new chapter in a long history of Cleveland Park. This only goes to reinforce our vision of creating community through people, parks, and programs. And as you see, each one of those was very, very well represented. And we couldn't be prouder for not only the profession and the fine folks that you have leading your parks department, but your vision and creativity. But better yet, the citizens of Spartanburg that came out and said, you know what, it is important. It's time. It's time for the healing to continue, but it's time for the new vision to take place in Cleveland Park. So we just want to, again, thank council for your vision and for your determination to continue to make this a success. Our public parks and recreation departments all over this state, we get to do a lot of great and wonderful things. We get to talk about economic impacts all day long. We get to talk about all these money that come in for all these ball tournaments all day long. But it's really about the community. That's what a public parks and recreation department is about, and the reinvestment in that community. And each one of you should be vibrant and holistically very, very proud of what you've done and the support that you have given the Spartanburg County Parks Department. So with that, I want to represent the 2016 Park Excellence Award, population over 30,000, Spartanburg County, Cleveland Park. Kevin?
Thank you for being here. Appreciate it, David.
Can I say just a quick word, Jim, before you step down? Kevin, before y'all leave, hang on just a second. Jim, I want to thank you and your team for presenting this team this award. We on council were just a small part of it, you know. And when you look at Cleveland Park, I've said this a lot of times about the new Spartanburg. And in Cleveland Park, if ever there's been an event or a facility that defines the new Spartanburg, this is it. Because you're right, a community came together. I mean, people in this room, many, many people came in here and gave up hours to go out there. And, you know, Marsha, your idea, I think it was your idea to do this community build or somebody within parks. I mean, it was fantastic. I just had someone this weekend bragging about Cleveland Park. They said, what a wonderful, wonderful facility it is, and, you know, all the kids playing, and they made so many nice comments about it. But this really is about who we now are, a community that has come together and stays together. We're not perfect, but we're working to be as close as we can be. Thank you for giving us this award.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you much. Next, we'll go to item 3, employee recognition, Catherine O'Neill. Catherine.
Mr. Chairman, I don't have any formal recognitions this evening, but we already have our lineup for November.
So okay, good deal.
We'll use our time now.
Okay, we'll go directly to item 4, conduct public hearings. First is item 8, to consider the issuance by the South Carolina Jobs Economic Development Authority of its economic development revenue bonds in one or more series, taxable or tax exempt, pursuant to the provisions of Title 41, Chapter 43 of the Code of Laws of South Carolina, 1976, as amended, in the principal amount not exceeding $14 million. Anyone to speak on behalf of this public hearing tonight? None seen. Close A. Open B. to consider an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee and lieu tax agreement by and between Spartanburg County, South Carolina, and Praxair Incorporated with respect to certain economic development property in the county, whereby such property will be subject to certain payments in lieu of taxes, including the provision of special source credits and other matters. Anyone speak on behalf of this public hearing? None seen, close B. Open C, to consider an ordinance to amend the agreement for development for a joint county industrial park by and between Spartanburg County and Cherokee County, South Carolina, so as to include additional properties in Spartanburg County as part of joint county industrial park and other matters related thereto. Anyone speak on behalf of item C? None seen, close C. Open D, to consider an ordinance to amend the agreement for development of joint county industrial park between Spartanburg County and Cherokee Counties as to enlarge the park for Trelleborg Coated Systems U.S. Incorporated. Anyone to speak on behalf of item D? None seen, close D. Open E, to consider an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee and lieu tax agreement and incentive agreement by and between Spartanburg County and Bank of America Leasing and Capital LLC, acting for itself, one or more affiliates and or project sponsors with respect to certain economic development property in the county, whereby such property will be subject to certain payments in lieu of taxes, including the provision of certain special source revenue credits. Anyone to speak on behalf of item E? None seen, close E. Open F, to consider an ordinance authorizing the conversion of a fee in lieu of ad valorem taxes arrangement under Title IV, Chapter 12, Code of Laws, South Carolina, 1976, as amended between Spartanburg County and Draxemeyer Service Incorporated as sponsor and DAA Draxemeyer Automotive of America LLC as sponsor affiliate to be simplified fee in lieu of ad valorem taxes arrangement under Title 12, Chapter 44, Code of Laws of South Carolina, 1976, as amended, the termination of certain lease agreement between Spartanburg County and the company, the conveyance by the county of related property of the company, the extension of the FILO term, and other matters related thereto. Anyone to speak on behalf of item F? None seen, close F. Open G, to consider an ordinance to provide certification of site requested by Upstate Developers LLC as provided by Section 12-65-60 of the South Carolina Textiles Communities Revitalization Act for certain property located at 2200 Racing Road, Greer, South Carolina, known as Appalach Mill. Anyone to speak on behalf of item G? None seen, close G. Open H, to consider an ordinance amending section of chapters 10 and ordinance 372, O-04-06, O-04-115, and O-09-26 of the Code of County of Spartanburg, South Carolina, to update and revise certain section of the building and building codes regulations chapter. Anyone to speak on behalf of item H? None seen, close H. Open I, to consider an application for a special public event exclusion from the noise ordinance requested by Jim Brannan from 10 a.m. until 11:59 p.m. on Friday, November 4, 2016, for an outdoor concert at 140 Double Bridge Road, Boiling Springs. Anyone to speak on behalf of item I? Unseen, close eye. And that concludes our public hearings. Earlier today, we had our committee reports. First committee was Economic Recruitment and Development. Honorable David Britt, Chairman. Mr. Britt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The committee met earlier, as you said, and we have five items that we need to bring before full council. The first item, we have a request to render first reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee and lieu tax agreement by and between Spartanburg County and Project IMC. I move that we render first reading to this ordinance.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on item A. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative and it passes.
Next item, the committee recommends the full council that we adopt a resolution regarding the extension of the investment period with respect to the 2012 FILO agreement between Spartanburg County and Milliken and Company. I move that we adopt the resolution.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on item B. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative and it passes.
Next item, committee recommends that full council we adopt a resolution authorizing under certain conditions the execution and delivery by Spartanburg County of a fee in lieu tax agreement by and between Spartanburg County and Project LS. I move that we adopt this resolution.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second on item C. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative and it passes.
Committee also on the next item recommends that we render first reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee in lieu tax agreement by and between Spartanburg County and a company known to the county at this time as Project LS with respect to certain economic development property. Move that we render first reading to the ordinance.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second on D. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I vote affirmative and it passes.
And the last item, committee recommends the full council that we render first reading to an ordinance to amend the agreement for development of a joint county industrial park by and between Spartanburg County and Cherokee County, South Carolina, so as to include additional property in Spartanburg County as part of the joint county industrial park and other matters relating thereto. And this is Praxar, Project IMC, Bank of America Leasing, and Irregular Polymers, Inc. I move that we render first reading to an ordinance.
Second.
All right, we have a motion and a second on item E. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative and it passes.
Mr. Chairman, that concludes our committee report. Full council.
Thank you, Mr. Britt. Keep them coming. No items under public health today. We have personnel and finance. Honorable Bob Walker, Chairman. Mr. Walker.
Mr. Chairman, the committee recommends that we take desired action in reference to a resolution regarding the issuance by the South Carolina Jobs Economic Development Party of its economic development revenue bonds in one or more series, taxable or tax exempt, pursuant to the provisions of Title 41, Chapter 43 of the Code of Laws of South Carolina, 1976, as amended, and in the principal amount of not exceeding $14 million. I move that we adopt this resolution.
Okay, we have a motion on item A and a B, second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative and it passes.
That concludes our report, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Walker. Livability Committee, Honorable Jane Hall, Chairman. Ms. Hall.
Yes, we received information and are here to take desired action in reference to an uncodified ordinance to transfer property to the City of Welford to assist in building a park to provide additional recreation facilities and programs to the citizens of Spartanburg County. The committee recommends the full council that we move and render first reading to this ordinance.
Okay. I have a motion on A and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. And opposed, I vote affirmative and it passes.
And that's all for our committee.
Thank you, Ms. Hall. Livability Committee, Public Safety and Judiciary Committee, Honorable Michael Brown, Chairman. Mr. Brown.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The committee recommends to this council that we support a free roaming cat program in Spartanburg County to implement the trap, neuter, and return method as an effective way to deal with stray and feral cats. I move that we adopt the resolution.
Second. Okay, we have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative and it passes.
That's all that came before committee.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Yes, ma'am, Ms. Hall.
I think one of the things that this council is recognizing and is taking action upon is the fact that we do need to take more involvement in our stray cats, and the TNR program is a wonderful program for us to do so. I hope this is only the first of many changes that we will do with our animal services. I think our animal services department does an excellent job, but there may be some areas in our ordinance that we need to change so that they can do a better job and be more efficient in what they are able to do. So I am hoping that in the future, that this is something that this council will take heed to and will look at these ordinances and see if there's other changes that we might need to make as well.
Thank you, Ms. Hall. Next, we have Public Works, Building and Ground, Honorable Roger Nutt, Chairman. Mr. Nutt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We're going to handle these one at a time.
All righty, Mr. Chairman.
The committee recommends, and I so move, that full council approves the first reading of an uncodified ordinance to grant a right-of-way easement for installing water system improvements along U.S. Highway 221 South, corridor across tax map parcel number 455-00018.00.
Second.
All right. We have a motion and a second on item A. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes.
Committee recommends, and I so move, that full council approves the first reading of an uncodified ordinance to grant a right-of-way an easement for installing a water system improvements along Kilgore Bridge Road across tax map parcel 4-41-00-073.01.
Second.
All right, we have a motion and a second on item B. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, no vote affirmative, it passes.
That is all we have, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Nutt. Next, we enter the public comment period. First person to sign up was Mr. Russell Lynch. Mr. Lynch.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Yes, sir. Council members. I want to reference a sentence in a recent Herald Journal article dated October 12th. The article was written by Daniel Gross of the Herald Journal, and the basis of the article was a pay study conducted by Dr. Kathleen Brady from USC Upstate for the Sheriff's Office. In short, the study sums up the current problems with the pay structure, offers some solutions, and most importantly, it warns of the repercussions for failing to address and fix the problem. The statement I'm referring to is that the situation at the Sheriff's Office is causing a threat to public safety. In that study itself, Dr. Brady states that if left unaddressed, the public safety will suffer. I don't believe the citizens have a clue that their safety is in jeopardy. They don't know that they are unprotected because the sheriff's office is understaffed and unable to maintain a stable workforce. When will the Spartanburg County Sheriff's Office stop throwing money into the black hole of the high cost of turnover and pay studies and address the problem at hand, restoring the taxpayers' blanket of security that the sheriff's office is responsible for providing? You would think that when the sheriff and his command staff read in their entirety the last two pay studies that advised him that the citizens he was sworn to protect, safety was in jeopardy, something would have been done to restore that service. But in January, when the results of the last study were received, it was not shared with anyone. In fact, it was hid from the citizens of Spartanburg County, or not revealed. It was not shared with you, the Spartanburg County Council, the very people who could help restore the problem and establish the level of protection the citizens of Spartanburg County deserve and should be demanding. As a United States Marine veteran and a retired police officer with 27 years of service, I know what it's like to be in situations where help cannot arrive to help you soon enough. The last thing that I think anyone in this county wants is for a citizen to experience the feeling of helplessness when they're in desperate need of someone to help them survive a violent encounter. What is the sheriff's office plan to fix this unacceptable problem? What will it take to be resolved? Neighboring agencies are taking appropriate measures to fix the problems in their jurisdictions and communities. It seems there has yet to be a price tag placed on fixing the lack of adequate protection from the citizens who have been unknowingly submitted to it. Will it be paid for with revenues or taxes? What is the price tag for safety? In closing, a fair comparison when it comes down to needing help and it falling on deaf ears is where U.S. Ambassador Chris Stevens has been requesting security for days, and all of his calls continue to fall on deaf ears. We're all aware of how that story ended. No one was held accountable then. Will that be the case in Spartanburg County today? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lynch. Next, we have Deborah James. Is Deborah here with us tonight?
Good
3 minutes. How are you today?
Good. I'm Deborah James. My husband and I live on Saluda Road in Moore, South Carolina. We have neighbors here tonight also. This is a new experience for us. Our neighborhood has always been calm, quiet, but recently we have a neighbor that has asked to open a food business on our street. He is using a food wagon in his front yard and is having a storage shed in his backyard. We understand we may not be able to change our situation, but maybe we can start a new process to change some rules for the future to help other residents in our county. Our community should not be allowing residents to start businesses in neighborhoods that change the whole outlook of that street. Residents on our street have lost value in their homes because of the visual eyesore this resident has caused by making his personal property a place to sell food. We had also received a letter that our address would probably be changing because of this new business. Today I found out that is being reevaluated and may not happen, but we're not sure at this time. We would just like to ask that Spartanburg County consider changing some of the rules or processes that allow certain residents to start businesses and change the whole atmosphere of their street or neighborhood. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. James. Thank you for being here. Next, we have our clerk, Hope Blackley.
Good evening.
Hi there.
Members of council, I wanted to come tonight to say a big thank you, especially to County Administrator Catherine O'Neill for working so diligently and my family, head of maintenance, during the remediation process at the courthouse. Things are hopefully, we're trying to get back to normal, but the attention that's been given to this, especially by our county administrator and our facilities director, was remarkable. And I wanted you all to know that, and I wanted to go on record so you could hear that directly from me. But I did want to also bring up some concerns, which I'm sure, I hope that you heard about over the weekend. And in the meantime, since there has been an area that has been found, I think Friday night I was notified by Mike Emery Saturday morning when we actually spoke of this area. Since then, it's actually been talk of the courthouse today, and I know Jay Mack is unavailable this week, but there have been some concerns that were presented to me today, this morning. This afternoon, I did have to step away about the air quality. I have called someone to just test it, just to hopefully reassure the occupants of the courthouse that the air quality is fine until we can have that remediation done. I was made aware of the remediation process that will take place this weekend. According to Mike Cameron, he told me this afternoon, this evening when I got here, that that will take place this evening. So I want to go over it to make sure that the employees and staff and members who come to the courthouse will know that we're in a good place. We know about what was found over the weekend. And that we're all actively working together to make sure that this problem is corrected. But I did want to go over it to say thank you. And thank you for allowing our county administrator and our county maintenance facility to help in this process. It's things are hopefully getting back to normal, and I'm glad to be back in. And to everybody in this building for allowing us to have court to operate out of this building, it went way better than what we could have ever planned for or expected. So I want to personally say thank you.
Well, thank you, Hope. I appreciate your comments tonight. That concludes the public comment period. We'll go to item 7-0 business. Item A, render third reading to an ordinance to amend section 6-2 of the Code of County of Spartanburg, South Carolina, to clarify the definition of a nuisance. Do we have a motion?
Move to approve on third reading.
And a second.
Second.
Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative and it passes. Item B, render third reading to an ordinance finding that Star Checks Jackson Welford Duncan Water District may issue not exceeding $15 million of general obligation bonds to authorize SJWD to issue such bonds and provide for the publication of notice of said finding.
So moved.
Have a motion. Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I vote affirmative and it passes. Item C, render second reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee and lieu tax agreement by and between Spartanburg and Prexair Incorporated with respect to certain economic development property in the county.
Move approval. Second reading.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on item C. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I vote affirmative and it passes. Item D, render second reading to an ordinance to amend the agreement for development of a joint county industrial park by and between Spartanburg and Cherokee County, South Carolina, so as to include additional property in Spartanburg County as part of joint county industrial park.
Would you approve the second reading?
We have a motion on D and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I vote affirmative and it passes. Item E, render second reading to an ordinance to amend the agreement for development of a joint county industrial park by and between Spartanburg and Cherokee County so as to enlarge the park for Trelleborg coated systems.
Move approval. Second reading.
Second.
Have a motion and a second on E. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I vote affirmative and it passes. Item F, render second reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of fee and lieu tax agreement and incentive by and between Spartanburg, South Carolina, and Bank of America Leasing and Capital.
Move approval on second reading.
Sorry. We have a motion and a second on F. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I vote affirmative and it passes. Item G, render second reading to an ordinance authorizing the conversion of a fee in lieu of ad valorem taxes arrangement under Title IV, Chapter 12, Code of Laws, South Carolina, 1976, as amended, for Draxamire Service Incorporated.
Move approval, second reading.
Have a motion and a second. On item G, any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I vote affirmative and it passes. Item H, render second reading to an ordinance to provide certification of site requested by Upstate Developers, LLC, as provided by Section 12-65 of 60 of South Carolina Textiles Communities Revitalization Act for certain properties located at 2200 Racing Road Greer, Appalachia Mill.
Move approval. Second reading.
We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I vote affirmative and it passes. Item I, render second reading to an ordinance amending sections of Chapter 10, Ordinance Numbers 372-04-06, 04-15, and 09-26 of the Code of Spartanburg County. We have a motion.
Second.
Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I vote affirmative and it passes. Next, we go to new business. Item A, consider an application for special public event exclusion from the noise ordinance requested by Jim Brannan from 10 a.m. until 11:59 p.m. on Friday, November 4, 2016, for an outdoor concert at 140 Double Bridge Road.
Did we approve the application?
Have a motion.
Sorry.
Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I vote affirmative and it passes. Any other resolutions, Catherine?
Yes, sir.
We need to approve our BARs under item 10, please.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? I vote affirmative. At the April 2016 County Council voted to change the date of the regular schedule 2016 November Council meeting to Monday, wow. November 14, 2016,
Russell,
the second Monday.
Before you leave, you may want to stick around.
I've got a son to pick up, my school hasn't picked up yet.
Well, I'm getting ready to address some of the things you said on the miscellaneous council matters. I kind of figured you would.
I need approval of minutes September 19, 2016.
Motion to approve.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, I vote affirmative, and it passes. Need a motion?
Under miscellaneous council matters, I'd like to say one quick thing, if I can. Not going to, you know, you got to go pick up your son. Since we opened up this time where anybody can come speak to anything, never heard anybody that's running for an office come before council and attack anybody, let alone, you know, a sheriff. The information that you presented last month had not been presented to council, had been presented to our county administrator, and the sheriff's department and our administration were working towards presenting that information to us in next year's budget session, where we could take it and hear it. Nothing was hidden from us. We didn't even know, the seven council members didn't even know there was a study done. And for you to come before council in the people's chambers tonight and attack in a campaign just irritates the ever-loving hound out of me. And, you know, this information that you presented last month and again referenced tonight in a political fashion, and it was being taped by your wife, I saw it, to put on your Facebook page, is wrong. That information was 2 years ago. We've had two salary increases for our deputies, along with every other employee in this room that happens to be an employee in Spartanburg County. So your information's old, it's outdated, it's not correct, it's not finalized, and I resent you coming before council and attacking the sheriff, the sitting sheriff, and presenting information to us like we're derelict in our duties. You make a comment about Benghazi is similar to, you know, the ambassador there. You're saying that we have left the citizens of Spartanburg unprotected, which is totally wrong. And I resent you doing that. And I don't take this job lightly. I take an oath every 4 years to protect the citizens of this county. And we do it, and I do it, and I take it very seriously.
You think I'm going to stand here and let you dress me down, sir?
Well, you just did us and the sheriff for 3 minutes.
I did not talk to you like you're talking to me.
Well, you
have already.
You deserve to be taught this way.
You have already threatened me and my family's reputation. And now you want to call me out in front of all these people in this council room. Is that correct, Nathan? Do I get a chance to respond to what you just said?
No, you came before the council. You attacked the sheriff who's not even here. You came to talk about things, and you attack and use this 3 minutes as a political forum.
The information I gave you is from January of this year.
And as far as you brought the matter up about me scaring you in June, I have a witness to my conversation to you. There was nothing but nice. I was totally nice to you. There was a gentleman last month that sat there when I talked to you. If you're afraid of me when I talk to you nice, you need to be talked to like this. You need to take it and learn from it.
There's no need for you to talk to me like you're doing right now, Mr. Britton, in front of all these people.
Well, you're welcome to go out that door if you don't like it.
Is that the way this is ran, Mr. Chairman? That he calls down a citizen in this county like this in his chamber room?
No, sir, but he did have a valid point that we were not privy to this information.
And that's exactly what I stated. I stated in what I read. Is right here.
That was leaked information to you that you weren't even supposed to have.
That information was
it was leaked to
the sheriff's office in January of 2016. You did not know anything about it. I was refused that information two times on FOIA requests. Twice.
So it was leaked information to you. Why don't you meet with the sheriff and talk to him about that? Don't come in here and make a political grandstand.
I talked to the sheriff last week and offered him that same thing. I've yet to get a phone call. That's between me and him, Mr.
Well, don't come before the council and take up our time and make accusations that he can't defend
himself. I was lost this time. I asked for it. I got it. I wouldn't give him any restrictions on what it was to be about.
When you said...
Did I violate the policy as to what that 3 minutes is for, Mr. Britt?
When you said that it's just like Benghazi, you put me in that. You weren't just attacking the sheriff then. You were attacking me and the other six council members here. And I resent that. I can sit there and take most anything. But when you start saying that, you're going to get it back from me.
Well, good. I hope you understand. You haven't got some schoolboy up here that you're going to dress down either.
Well, if you were scared from my conversation in June, where I asked you to come meet
Britton,
my office, and you called sled on me.
I have got a family that's got a different attitude about somebody making a threat than I do. I'll assure you.
To ask you to come to my office and have lunch is a threat?
Okay, Mr. Britton. Is there anything else, sir? Any reasonable questions or anything I'd be glad to address them?
No, I don't have any questions of you. I just want to make a statement. And the people out here deserve that. You got up here and you made a 3-minute political speech. and attack the sitting chair for things that he did not do.
Mr. Pruitt, is there a problem with the topic that I talked about? I was given these 3 minutes. I was not given any guidelines. I didn't get called down the last time. Why am I called down this time? I don't understand, Mr. Pruitt.
I didn't know anything about the survey last time. It was a two-year-old survey based on our old survey, based on a survey based on two-year-old wages. And you knew it.
Yeah, that's right. And the hole has got
deeper. But you make it look like it's so much worse.
The hole has got deeper since then. That's just another dollar figures added to it since the 2 years old figures. That's what the Association of County had when Kathleen, Dr. Brady had done that. That's the number
2 years old information. You got your medicine that you dished out.
All right, I need a motion. Yeah. I need a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Thank you for your attendance.